take a person and lay them on the ground.
Yes, sir.
And take a knife. Wow. And scrape all of the top skin.
Yes, sir.
All their body, you wouldn't see nothing but flesh. And then you see ants.
All
right. All I can tell you. Now you see Jordan's problem. You can see why he's supposed to be going to stand and he ended up in Sunset. You can understand that now. I mean, what one of the things about the folk in it, they will put you on a pole with no clothes on and let you hang in the sun to die.
Yeah. All right.
Now, who you know want to go there? Let me pick up something about New York for you. You ain't gonna just go by Brownfield community in New York because you ain't got no real stuff. Matter of fact, you don't want to walk through that.
Alright.
Not accidentally. Unless you got about 2-3 guns on you. I got a couple of them, they don't want to come in. Especially the Bogey and Chester. There are some places you just don't want to walk in some areas of New York. Matter of fact, Memphis is getting so bad in certain areas. I thought I would pick you up, man. In some neighborhoods, you ain't talking about just hanging out in. Because the folks are so bad. So now I can understand Jonah's motive, because guess what? He didn't want to do what the Lord wanted him to do, because sometimes, I got some preachers there. God don't always want you to preach to the sweet folk. I know my preachers ain't gonna talk to me. So, sometimes God has to get you with some ruthless people.
Yes, sir.
That don't care nothing about Jesus. And don't care nothing about you. But he wants you to preach the word. Come and preach something. That's why he came to preach in season. Oh, now y'all ain't coming. Now y'all come on. In season and out of season. See, you just can't do this when you want to do it. He said, go cry out. To the mean and ruthless people and men. He called them wickedness, wicked, because he says, cry out against them, for their wickedness has come up before me. Now, it's bad enough, ladies and gentlemen, right, when you do something to get on somebody in your house new. Now, let me find some couples in here that sometimes some folk in your house can really work you. Where the other room looks better. Don't make me call you a name. I mean, you love him, but you say, I can't stand you today. I'm coming. Let me ask something. Let me get some of these men here, because I know y'all didn't talk to about the words and everything. When she just start talking and don't stop. See, y'all ain't gonna say that. Boy, I'm messing up in here now. She just, 3 o'clock in the morning, she wanna have a full blown conversation.
Look at Miss Calhoun.
And you talking about I'm sleeping. She said, but I want to talk. She said, but I want to talk now. You ought not to be asleep. I want to talk. Then call you all the next day, and you just leave the voicemail alone. You hear her voice saying, you know it's me. Answer that phone. make you lose your job. Your boss asks you, why your phone going? I mean, these folk were so wicked. I mean, they caused nothing but havoc for the man of God. I want to help you with something. I got to get out of here now. Yes, sir. God knows how to cause some interruption. But here's the thing that I really want to take. His interruptions are always designed to redirect you. Y'all miss it. Because, Thomas, guess what I realized? Sometimes, where I want to go is not where God wants me to go. Sometimes, your direction is not always a good direction. Let me find somebody in here. Just ever fell off the la-la truck at least once with your direction. Where you made up your mind, that's what you want to do, but in what God wants you to do. Come close and talk to me. And you sitting here this morning paying the consequences. God has a way of redirecting you. Sometimes he got to let death come in your life. You want to see God clear, let mama die. You really want to see God clear? Let bad pass. Especially if you got a good one. Let one of your close relatives pass. Something happen. And watch God make you know him better. Matter of fact, God say, foolishness that I used to do. I ain't doing no more because I ain't got much time. And you got a chance, if you sitting here this morning thinking that you got a long time to live, I drop by on my way to heaven to tell you, time is winding up. So Mike, he'll let you have a back pain. To teach you how to pick up something different. He'll teach you a different method. When you just used to grab, now all of a sudden you he's and I got some folk in here right now. He's really redirected your mind. And you got to let God redirect your life. Because I know I got friends here that can understand this. Your way hadn't always been the best way. The next thing I got to get out of here. Y'all ain't never got out of church. So my grandma, he interrupts you so that he can give you a new ride. It gives you a whole new direction to go. And somebody here really thank God that God let some stuff happen in life, man, to give you a new direction. I need to speak to my crowd in here this morning that's dealing with failure. You in here this morning. Is not fine. Oh man, that was you should have got one program right there. Failure is not, you messed up.
Yes, sir.
You made some bad decisions. Lace your bootstraps up. Get over it. And move on. Other crowd in here now. You sitting in here with me this morning. You got no self-esteem. Baby, let me help you with something. Ain't nobody sitting next to you, behind you, and in front of you any better than you. Like they got it going on. Like they got more money than you. Like they ain't never had no trouble. You just hadn't seen them behind the door. You know, I don't care how many pastors it is in Memphis. I don't feel like nobody better than I am. And I'm talking about on a good day. See, if you don't believe in you, then why do you expect anybody else to believe in you? Lord, shall I know? And the next thing that I want to tell you, that he has a way of realigning your life. Now watch this. Lester, you ain't ready for this. He'll fix it so that folk you used to hang out with.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. This side ain't even talking. Man, he'll remove some folk.
Yes, sir.
That should have been gone in the first place. Imagine when folks said, I ain't talking him good. Better that you remove yourself than I remove you. Somebody says something wrong with you, you know what you would do.